to stand tall. Welcome back to Passionate Characters. I'm your host, Naomi, and this is Passionate Characters, where we highlight everyday individuals who are passionate, driven, and have goals to succeed. All right, today's guest is Kristian. Thank you so much for coming out. All right, now let's get onto the show, everybody. On to the main question, what are you passionate about?
I'm passionate about fitness. I'm passionate about entrepreneurship. I'm passionate about my community that I'm in. Right now, we're just changing the perspective when it comes to fitness and mental health. Mm-hmm. That's what I'm passionate about, really. Yeah.
And how did you get on this journey?
Well, I got on this journey, it was really unexpected in a sense, because I was a football player. So I was playing college football, and I got picked up by arena football teams.
Okay.
But I had big hopes of going to NFL and things like that, because I was actually talking to NFL scouts and doing that whole process of hopefully being selected for the NFL draft in 2017. I kind of felt depressed in a sense, because I did want to play big ball, not the arena football, and so training just fell in my lap out of nowhere. I think it's the purpose that God put me on to actually pursue is fitness and training and really focusing on my community when it comes to mental health. That's a big issue. To really start your ass, but also turn your whole body. Pretty much it's like four rounds, 16 exercises. So each round is 2 minutes long.
So it's intense.
Yeah.
Okay, so you came up with the names all by yourself.
A lot of people, I always seek advice on. I'm not the mastermind behind everything. I'm not self-made. So a lot of people that help me come up with different names, different concepts. Even by my research, I research a lot. I study some of the top trainers, some of the top boutique fitness studios, some of the top gyms in the country. And I'm trying to install it into my business model. So I do a lot of research and studying on marketing and everything else. So, and I seek advice. Not one of those people always gonna call me young guy. I'm not one of those entrepreneurs that think that they know it all.
Yeah.
So I always seek advice. I want a great mentor. And I listen. I try to install what they're saying to me into my model that works for me.
Okay. Yeah. All right. So talk to us about how you got here to own this establishment.
Yeah.
Did you know you'd be here? Was this location easy to get?
No. So basically, I was a mobile trainer at first. I used to work at LA Fitness as well, but I was a mobile trainer. So pretty much, I was at a location. I was underneath an umbrella of another trainer at a studio. So I was an independent contractor there. Just a little fallout, and I was looking for a location that wasn't too far from where I was already at. And so I was researching and looking up some places. I had two locations. I liked this one when I first came in here. It was big enough, it was reasonable pricing and everything. And I got it. It was kind of challenging to lock in on it because I never had a background of owning an establishment.
Mm-hmm.
At the time, I just bought. I just got into an apartment. I live in my home. So at the time last year, so it's been 8 months since I had this. So everything was new when it came to talking to leasing agents and the whole terminology. So
wow.
That was a challenging part. Just trusting me.
What a thing to jump into.
I know. Yeah. I think everything is meant to be. I didn't know what to expect it. So I'm just following God's plan.
So, three words. What is it like to be a business owner? 3 words. How do you describe it?
It's rewarding. It's challenging. And it's inspiring. Rewarding because you have the potential of gaining financial freedom based on your hard work and your ambitious ways. Challenging when it comes to just running the business and learning the business aspect, because many of us are talented in a lot of things that we do, so talent can't carry you the whole way. Learning the business aspect of things and how to negotiate and organization is a lot.
You said inspiring.
Inspiring. It's inspiring because when I do my studying and I look up, a lot of the business owners around that I can relate to that are doing very well for themselves. It inspired me to keep going. I learned that inspiring aspect when I was playing college football and even a pro when I played arena. I would go to my cousin's high school games, and that would inspire me from I felt new, getting that new feeling, that new vibe, to keep you inspired, keep you going.
Okay. Yeah. Wow. So I want to talk about challenging. And when I think of owning my own business, I can only imagine how challenging that might be. Because we see this here, we see what came about, how it looks on the aesthetics, but we don't know the background, what it took you to get here, and what it takes you to keep it running.
Yeah.
So talk to us about what it takes you to keep it running. What are some things you have to go through?
Pretty much staying creative. One of the cool things about being a business owner is when there's a rough time in your business, which is always going to be, hopefully eventually it never would be once you perfect your craft, but it gives you the chance to be creative and come up with new ideas. Really just, don't follow the trends of what's going on. Being your own person, being your own business model. That's challenging in the sense to remain creative. You gotta really
be current.
Yes, yeah.
How do you stay relevant?
Yeah, and I grabbed a lot of my business model in the sense from Drake.
So this DC expansion, what made you do that?
So pretty much House of Abs. Abundant Fitness is really a place for group training, different classes, not one of the typical gyms where you just come in the gym and just lift weights, whatever you want to do, a membership basis, like Planet Fitness with those. It's really to get that one-on-one attention almost and keep it very, intimate. So when I feel like it's starting to grow a little bit more than what I expected to, and people really come here for that. One-on-one experience almost, it's time to expand the program. So House of Abs actually been only going since January, and we are in June, so the fact that it's expanding so fast, it's amazing. DC is a great market for fitness. It's the number three fittest city in the world. It's New York number one, San Francisco, and Washington, D.C. is our backyard. So that is a place for fitness, and it fits perfectly at the location that we'll be at.
So would you say, if we take a look at, in comparison, owning your own business to working for somebody, what would you think is the best?
Owning your own business, no matter what, in my opinion. I mean, I had many experiences where I felt like the hierarchy wasn't I just feel like those hierarchy people, like the managers, just wasn't qualified for those positions to be talking. A lot of times I have terrible experiences with managers were very disrespectful, and I handled it in an excellent way by putting them aside and saying, "Hey, I don't like talk to you like this. I'm a man with responsibilities as well. So I am a human being." And so sometimes people take advantage of their positions, and I never liked that. To me, the issue was working with good people were being talked to like I was a peanut, which I don't do for nobody. I respect everybody I talk to. I give everybody the time of day because I'm nobody. We all the same in a sense. That's why I never understand why people talk to people a certain way. Everybody deserves the same respect.
And why should people choose Abundant Fitness?
You should choose Abundant Fitness because it is the premier boutique gym in Prince George's County. This is the family type atmosphere, and it's really results driven as well. So you just don't come in here like a regular gym. There's trainers in here to really help you towards the fitness goals. So it's a one-stop shop for everything that you need. You definitely want to lose your body fat and get this belly fat nice and toned up. Abundant Fitness is a place for you.
That's the end of our show. Guys, thank you so much for coming out. Thank you for meeting Kristian, and thank you for talking with me. All right, see you at the next episode. Thank you. Bye.